A copyrighted presentation of the Southwest Athletic Conference in conjunction with Raycom Sports and Entertainment.
1969, college football centennial year, the last day of the season, Texas versus Arkansas. Both teams undefeated, untied, rated number one and number two nationally, with the victor to become the undisputed national champion. A minute and a half after the opening kickoff, Bill Burnett puts the Razorbacks on top 7-0. In the third quarter, Arkansas strikes again as Bill Montgomery fires to All-American receiver Chuck Dykus to make it 14-0. As the fourth quarter opens, James Street, behind the blocking of Bobby Wunsch and Bob McKay, outstreaks the Razorback defenders to make it 14-6. Street gambles for 2 points on a counter option, and he gets it. Now it's 14-8. After this crucial interception by Danny Lester, Texas begins a last-ditch drive. Facing a critical fourth down and three, Street shuns all caution and goes for the bomb. Randy Peschel gathers it in at the Arkansas 13. 2 plays later, Jim Bertelson bashes over to tie the score. Happy Feller adds the point after, and Texas takes the game and the national championship, 15-14.
Today, Arkansas and Texas reunite for the 20th anniversary of the Big Shootout. Raycom Sports and Entertainment presents Southwest Conference Football. Today's game is brought to you by Dr. Pepper and Dr. Pepper Bottlers. By Jefferson Pilot Life Insurance Company. By British Airways. By Phillips 66. And by GTE. 53,000 seats have been gone for weeks for this one, the 71st renewal of the rivalry between the Longhorns and the Razorbacks. And happy to have you with us again. Dave Barnett along with Dave Rowe. When you talk about the great rivalries in college football, you can group this one with maybe 5 or 6 others in a class by themselves.
And as is true with a rivalry, throw out all the records, throw out all the schedules, throw out all the statistics, because the front page said it all. This is the game.
And it's got that historical tinge because it is the 20th anniversary of the shootout. James Street helped Texas win that one. Peter Gardere has shown a little Street in him in the last 2 wins.
Well, he certainly has in his leadership. Although those completion and attempts are not really indicative of what he has led this team to, the biggest statistic is that he is 2-0 as a starter. And watch this play against Rice. He stretches, knows exactly where the end zone is, and stretches in, and they win.
And then, of course, in the Cotton Bowl last week, leading the final drive after the Longhorns had lost every game from 1984 on against the Sooners, the 25-yard pass to Johnny Walker for the touchdown, and Texas pulled off the 28-24 upset. Arkansas comes into this game not exactly unarmed, especially at running back.
Oh, boy, they have a select group of running backs. They actually have 6. These 4 are hog heaven for Kenny Hatfield. Foster, Harshaw, Rouse, and Jackson. The big one is Foster, though, with a 6.2-yard average. Every time he touches the football, he has yet to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage this year.
And last year, they ran the flex bone all the way to the Cotton Bowl. They've changed to the I formation with still some option this year, but the trigger man is still the same, and that's Quinn Grovey.
He's the leader of this team. As he goes, so go the Razorbacks. Look at that average per carry, 7.3 yards. They'd like to have him carried a little bit less, but he is an awesome runner back.
Well, Arkansas is favored by about 2 touchdowns in this game, even though Texas has won each of their last 3 trips into the hills of Arkansas. So we are very close to kickoff tonight as the Razorbacks take on the Longhorns here in Fayetteville.
Wow. Black Rock, Nevada, and Old Milwaukee both mean something great to these guys. Black Rock means land sailing, riding the wind across dry desert lakes. And Old Milwaukee means a great beer, cold, crisp Old Milwaukee beer, and smooth, golden Old Milwaukee light.
There's nothing like the flavor of a special place, an Old Milwaukee beer.
Old Milwaukee and Old Milwaukee light.
You know, guys, it doesn't get any better than this.
If you want a little muscle in your car, forget your old routine. You gotta pump up. Pump up to Super Clean Premium. Performance power from Phillips 66.
So, 2 years in New York, and he thinks he can tell us how to run things.
It's all right.
Back here in Fayetteville, this is a Texas-dominated series, although the home team, as you can see, has not won since 1984. It had been since 1966 that Arkansas had not won in Austin, but they pulled that off for the last two trips in. And as we said, Texas is three for their last three here in Arkansas. It's a little bit cool today and very windy. It's a swirling type wind. And David McWilliams was wondering what he should do if he won the toss, and he won it and elected to defer. Arkansas will kick off, and McWilliams just hope he can pull off the magic for three straight weeks.
It was interesting. Both coaches came up as we look at David McWilliams and asked me when I was down there. They said, well, what would you do, take the wind or take the ball? And Kenny Hatfield said, I said, what are you going to do, coach? That's your decision. He said, I don't know right now. I'm putting it off.
53,000 rise to their feet here at Razorback Stadium. They've been waiting for this one a long time. The Arkansas Razorbacks, number six in one poll, number seven in another, and the Longhorns hoping if they can capitalize on what they did to the Sooners last week, they might be able to sneak into a poll. Arkansas has only won in Fayetteville three times against Texas in school history, and the last time Texas came in number one in the nation in 1981, but not for long. Len Ray Hines' kick taken and down to the end zone by Tony Jones. And Peter Gardere, the redshirt freshman, and by the way, it is Gardere, not Gardere, his dad says, comes in from Houston Lee in his third consecutive start. And along with Gardere in the backfield for the Longhorns will be Chris Samuels at the tailback. Winfred Tubbs and Jason Burleson will alternate at fullback. And Burleson is in the huddle right now with the fine receiving core of Jones, Walker, and Cash. And up front, Cunningham leads an outstanding offensive line, one that seems to improve every week.
Really important that they get off to a good start. They need confidence in their offense.
And they fake the end around. This is Samuels. Still haven't gotten him, and he's got a first down up near the 34-yard line. 13, 14 yards for Samuels after they faked the give to Tony Jones.
Well, the fake was so quick, and they have to be aware that Tony Jones is that great running back. He has four runs, and they have to be aware of that. But this is just basic football, just try to get around the corner. He makes a nice cut back in there. Samuels is a heads-up player, looking back inside, pick up every yard. That's what you want to do. You want to get confidence in this offense and take the crowd out of it. This is a massive crowd.
Tubbs is in now. He's the fullback in the eye. And Samuels again with a huge hole up the middle, and he is up near midfield. 15 yards this time for Chris Samuels, and another first down before Anthony Cooney, the weak side cornerback, made the stop for Arkansas. Up front, Long, Roland, and Shepard. Will also see a lot of Tony Ollison at one defensive tackle. Benson, Barrow, Thomas, and Mason in the 3-4. And the secondary is outstanding with James Williams Jackson, the converted running back, and Cooney, who just made the tackle. Opened up two gaping holes already on the first two offensive plays. Flagged down, early movement by Texas, and again, nice running room for Samuels. But they will apparently move back the 6 or 7 yard pickup. The referee is Frank Shepard.
Well, that's going to show you illegal motion against Texas, but what an interesting play on that one. They bring the wing back in, and they trap on the middle linebacker. And there, of course, is a Texas must. What they must do to win, they have to maintain the confidence that they got last week, especially with that great win over Oklahoma. They have to slow Arkansas's great running attack. Arkansas coming into this game is averaging about 5.5 yards a carry, 340 40 yards a game. And of course, involve Tony Jones more. He's been kind of quiet, and he's such a dynamic player.
And of course, as they double team him, that has led to the emergence of Johnny Walker in their passing game.
This is Adrian Walker, the redshirt freshman from Tyler, and Bubba Barrow does not allow him the corner.
The way you stop a sweep, run it all the way to the sidelines, and when they run out of room, they step on the white stripe outside. Nice play there by Bubba Barrow.
First time they've tried to go wide since that opening fake reverse sweep. They've had the holes up the middle.
Yeah, they really did. Now it's going to put a lot of pressure on Gardere.
Second down, and we'll call it 16 from their own 44-yard line. And the straight drop. Open over the middle is Kerry Cash, and he can't find his feet.
Well, I was down on that turf, and the turf is a little bit slippery down there. It's a well-packed turf. It's not a new turf, so when he turned around, he just lost his footing.
Cash, of course, one of the twin Cash brothers, the juniors from San Antonio. We expect to see a lot of Keith today as well. And a gain of only four on the second down play. So third and long. And the penalty really looming large for Texas after they had come out of the chute so well. Jones, the man in motion, and Gardere again straight back. Outstanding protection, and he's got Johnny Walker, and the Horns have another first down. The 33 of Arkansas, where Ty Mason makes the tackle after a gain of 18.
Well, he had all the time in the world to throw. Watch Walker come down there. He's just going to curl inside. He gives a little fake outside, and all he's going to do is curl right back inside. Now he's a big target because there's no rush on him. The defensive line, they elected to rush three, drop eight back, and there was no rush on Gardere.
This is how Texas opened offensively last week against OU. Walker, more big running room. And 8 yards on this first down carry. Again, into the secondary, and Cooney called on to make the stop.
And boy, I'll tell you one thing, it has taken the crowd. The crowd right now is stunned. I mean, everyone, there's 50-some thousand people here, and they're all dressed in red, and they are quiet. They cannot believe that Texas has taken this ball from its own 20 and now driven to the 26-yard line of Arkansas.
And particularly the way they've done it. They're only the sixth best rushing team in the Southwest Conference. You would never know that from this opening drive. On second and two, Samuels cut back inside, first down. Tackle made by Nick Thomas, who's the leading Arkansas tackler. The sophomore out of Bakersfield, California, and the Horns continue to march.
Well, in talking with David McWilliams and, of course, his staff, they said the one thing that Gardere has in the huddle is that he's a leader. When he gets in there, he doesn't have that glazed over look like a freshman has. He's got the confidence, and he's in that huddle right now taking charge, saying, don't fumble, don't give this ball up. We're in great scoring position, and we are on a march.
His numbers for the year, took over as the starter a couple of weeks ago. They're glad he did. Do stop him. They caught that hole, and it was Nick Thomas, one of the inside linebackers. And really, Dave, the first time they've done that.
It really is. It's the first time they've been able to stop him. One thing that Texas did in those first three or four runs is they sustained their blocks very well. It was a little bit slow getting in there, but they sustained their blocks. And when you sustain your blocks, that means that you've got that defensive man tied up where he can't come off and make that tackle, and that's why they were able to find the hole. Big play here, second down. I know they have, of course, two more downs, but this is a big down. You want to get at least 5 or 6 yards on this play to put the pressure back on the defense.
And three wideouts, and Walker and Jones both wide right. Now Jones into your picture in motion. And here is the end around, and there is where it will end. At the 33-yard line, as footing again becomes a problem.
Well, I talked about the turf being a packed turf. Someone told me yesterday, I can't recall who it was, but someone said they are going to replace this turf. But watch how wide open Tony Jones was on this play. Now, there's no one even near him. He just slips and goes down. You can see they had a great block out there. There was no one even close to him. Boy, that is a big play.
Jones this year has averaged 11.4 on his receptions. But on running plays, he's averaged nearly 22 yards per carry. That's why they went to him there.
Boy, and it was there.
So they need 21 yards on third down. Gardere again, a lot of time, and he's got Kerry Cash. He will not
at the 17-yard line. Barrow and Jackson converging for the stop.
And if Arkansas elects to run those three linemen up there, they're only allowing three linemen to rush. That big offensive line of Texas can certainly control them. You almost have to blitz somebody to get pressure on this young quarterback. You have to rattle him. Right now they're not rattling him. He has all the time in the world to stand back there.
Clemens will try a 34-yarder. The angle is left to right. And out of the hold of Bobby Liljedahl, he has got it up and good.
And the kick is good.
And listen how quiet the crowd is. You can hear whistles down on the field.
There are a few folks in orange, and you can hear them. And the Longhorns have come out very strong on their first possession here in Fayetteville.
Interesting exhibit, isn't it?
Standpoint.
Oh, you are absolutely correct. Listen, I was wondering.
Oh, Dr. Penrose.
Just what the doctor ordered.
Would you like to share that with a tall, dark stranger?
For your perfect personality.
If you want power, if you want performance power, don't just pump. Pump up. Pump up to Super Clean Premium. Performance power from Phillips 66.
Today's game is brought to you in part by Old Milwaukee Light. Texas takes the opening kickoff, drives it down, and until Tony Jones fumbles on an end around where it looked very much like he might score, he had everything in front of him. They have to settle for the 34-yard Wayne Clemens field goal after a 10-play drive. It ate up over 5 minutes, and the Horns lead it 3-0.
Well, you run that reverse play when you get that over pursuit, and Arkansas had pursued strongly. They had the perfect block on the backside, but Tony Jones just slipped down on the turf. We talked about it, and then we were down on the field, and it is a very packed artificial turf. Most turfs have a grain to it. This was kind of crunched and kind of flattened. They say the turf is about 6 or 7 years old, and they're going to replace it within a year or two.
And you saw where Barry Foster is awaiting this kick. He's all the way up to the 10-yard line because Clemens kicks into that stiff breeze, and he rolls it. And picked up at the 20 by Juju Harshaw. Flag is down, so we'll have to see if the Razorbacks are going to hang on to this good field position at the 37-yard line.
Well, where that flag is down, you would almost think it was the receiving team offside because the flag is thrown right on the 50-yard line.
Well, it was the kicking team.
Oh, it was the kicking team that was offside. I was half right. Okay. And here's Kenny Hatfield saying, no way, no way. We'll take the ball right where we have it on the 37-yard line and be happy.
And Quinn Grovey into the Arkansas huddle, the junior out of Duncan, Oklahoma, one of the great running quarterbacks they have ever had here. And James Rouse, one of 3,000-yard runners in Arkansas history, along with Foster in the backfield. You saw the receivers, and here is their outstanding offensive line, led by Apolskis and Mabry at the tackles.
Boy, and it's a solid line. They play smash-face football, just power football, come right at you. They don't try to fool you.
An I-formation team this year. This is big James Rouse, and he powers for 3 or 4 off right tackle. Ken Hackamack made the stop for Texas, and they are a little bit banged up on the defensive side, especially in the secondary. Steve is hurt, but he starts along with Allen, Hackamack, and Giles up front. And then the linebackers, led by Brian Jones. The secondary has been scrambled. Stanley Richard is not with the team, ankle problem, so Barry and Bierman start at the corners. Van Malone also has opened in the secondary, and he is a true freshman. We'll also see Gunn and Graylin Johnson back there. Again, straight up the middle, look at the hole for Barry Foster, and he's got the first Arkansas first down of the day.
Boy, that's just power football. Nice cut there when he cuts back. And you'll see when he finds the hole, it's really not at the point of attack. He cuts back to his left when he gets into the hole. Now watch here from the end zone. Right there's the play design. Now watch the good cut back. Sees that hole open up right there? That's the difference between gaining 4 yards of carry and gaining, as he does, 6.2, is that he has great vision into the hole.
fifth leading rusher in the conference, and he has not played anywhere near an entire game because they have so much depth. Tight end Billy Winston was in motion. And the option pitch to Rouse, and he slides on that turf at the 48-yard line of Texas. We talked about what Texas has to do. Now turn it around for Arkansas.
Well, Arkansas must take control early. They have not done that, but they allowed Texas to drive the length of the field, and I know that's a big concern. When we talk about dominate the special teams, we know the great field goal kicker, but there are also other aspects of that game. Coverage, punt, and punt blocks. And, of course, rattle the quarterback, rattle Gardere. Get him nervous out there. Let him start thinking that, hey, I am a freshman, ain't I?
Harshaw has checked in for Foster at the tailback slot. That was Russell in motion. Roby on a roll. A lot of room. And finally, Anthony Krill knocks him out of down out of bounds, but there is a late flag on what looked to be an Arkansas clip back near the 40.
Boy, and if you're an Arkansas fan, you're going to like it. If you're a Texas fan, you're going to question it because you're going to see one. Maybe we can see on the replay. There's the call. It is clip against Arkansas. It looked as if Groby, and you can see Kenny Hatfield out there saying, now, wait a minute. Watch on the right of your screen here. Watch. Now, watch right here where he turns back on him. Right there is what they called. That's the clip that they called. Boy, that's a tough call.
That was Barry Foster.
Yeah. And it's a tough call. You see, he was running with him side by side, and then when he turned, he really didn't knock him down, but the referee, and he's in the right position to make the call.
There's his crew along with Shepard. We've got Bill Anger, Bob Jones, Ron Underwood, Rogers Redding, Bill McClure, and Ron Murphy. Each team now victimized by a major penalty after they'd shown the early ability to move the ball. Almost at will.
And this really changes the complexion of this drive because all of a sudden you start thinking it's second down now. It's about 18 yards, 16, 17 yards to go. And all of a sudden you can't run the ball twice and pick up 17 yards.
Arkansas with two tight ends along with Billy Winston. Steve Hudson has checked in. Only one setback. That's Foster. Groby on play action again flushed out. And Brian Jones and Paul Bierman chase him out. And the Hogs want a late flag, but they won't get it.
Oh, boy. They did. When a quarterback is running out of bounds and he eases up when he hits that white stripe, usually you don't touch him. They felt, watch this, as he hits that white stripe. Now watch him just kind of relax here. Now he's still in bounds, and he kind of gets shoved. That's not a real vicious shove, but boy, those coaches reacted like it was. If you're from Texas, you think it is. I mean, if you're from Arkansas, you certainly thought it was.
Grovey's got to be wondering. They call him out of bounds at the 44, so third down and 15. They need the Texas 41 to keep the drive going. Horton is wide to the left. Russell at the top of your screen to the right. And again, Groby rolling. Good protection. Ball is intercepted by Anthony Curl, the freshman from Aldine MacArthur.
What great concentration. Groby threw this ball up, and really, when he was running, he didn't get the velocity on the ball that he wanted. The ball was tipped up. Now watch right here. It's going to be tipped up. Good concentration. Looking back on the ball. There's the interception.
Arkansas, not a turnover-prone team, but they've given it up.
Logan Pass Montana and Old Milwaukee both mean something great to these guys. Logan Pass means trailblazing, exploring the wilderness of Glacier National Park. And Old Milwaukee means a great beer. Cold, crisp Old Milwaukee beer and smooth, golden Old Milwaukee light.
There's nothing like the flavor of a special place. And Old Milwaukee beer.
Old Milwaukee and Old Milwaukee light.
Guys, it just doesn't get any better than this.
If you want power, if you want performance power, don't just pump. Pump up. To Super Clean Premium. Performance power from Phillips 66.
Big interception by Anthony Curl has given the Horns the ball at their 35-yard line. We talked about Arkansas. Over the last 5 years, they lead the nation in turnover ratio. They're only plus one, however, this year, and it's Texas which is doing the better job.
Right, that's the difference when you fumble and throw interceptions as compared to when you get interceptions and recover fumbles.
This is the first college carry by Lanell Foreman. The thought was that they would redshirt him. He was one of their top recruits out of Del City, Oklahoma. 6 feet, 185 pounder. And one of the top running backs in all of America among the high schoolers last year. But they've got him in there, and he has a pickup of 3 yards on first down.
And when you're in a game like this, in a rivalry like this, you pull out all the stops.
Jones is to the right, Walker to the left. And Kerry Cash in motion. Once again, this is Foreman. I love his feet. He's got a first down and tripped up, or he would have had six, but another flag is down. This one back at the line of scrimmage.
I didn't even see this one. It looks like it's going to be holding. Oh, boy, that really hurts Texas' drive. Instead of having the ball at the 45-yard line of Arkansas, first down, they're going to be backed up way in their own territory. Well, that is a big, big penalty.
And penalties have been the controlling factor in this game so far.
They are the killers on offense. People don't realize that, but most teams, most offensive teams stop themselves with a penalty or with a mistake. Let's see if perhaps we can see this. Look on the right side of your screen. Let's see who we have here. Looks like Chad Rowland, 51, got held.
Well, Patrick McFarland is the center for Texas. Wayne Miller, Jeff Boyd are the guards, and it was the inside blocking that caused that penalty. Foreman again. Not much. 32, maybe the 33-yard line. And Mason and Thomas, those very active inside linebackers, combined on the stop. Arkansas defensively, second in the conference. And overall, 13th in the nation. They allow only an average of 267 total yards per game.
And boy, are they good on third down. When we talk about third down conversions, this is about third down and 12. This Arkansas team has held their opponents to only 28% conversions on third down.
Samuels is back into the backfield, along with Tubbs, and here's Gardere having to make it up as he goes. Intercepted by Curtis Banks. In between Cash and Jones, really hard to see who the intended receiver was for Gardere.
Gardere had hesitation on this in that he thought about running, then he thought about passing. And you see him getting up with Tony Jones. Good move there by the young quarterback to turn around and say, hey, get open. Wave those hands and let me know where you are on the scramble.
Bobby Liljedahl, second leading punter in the conference. Tim Horton is the deep returner for the Arkansas Razorbacks, standing at his 28-yard line. And into that win, this will get a Texas roll. And downed by Jeff Higgins at the 29-yard line. We'll see the Arkansas offense for the second time. They trail here in Fayetteville as we play midway first quarter.
So, 2 years in New York, and he thinks he can tell us how to run things.
It's all right. I fix things. He's traveling overnight on the red eye.
Not first class.
Business class, of course. Company policy.
He'll be hungry and tired.
Clunk, British Airways' new business class delivers you ready for business.
Pleasant trip.
Yes, thank you.
New club class for the businessman, only from the world's favorite airline.
Until recently, my job was a nice job. I made sure everyone in our company understood our insurance benefits package, especially me. But then they started to make all these new rules and regulations. Do you know what COBRA is? Let me tell you, it's not a reptile. And Section 89? No. I still haven't found anyone to explain that one. Oh, and then there's this thing called Tefra. It's funny. I used to think that was a shampoo.
Jefferson Pilot Insurance and Financial Services.
Just about 6 minutes to go in the first quarter. Texas has been a surprise, I would say, offensively early, despite that possession.
Easily a big surprise. Be able to move the ball with the efficiency that they moved in that first drive. The second drive, the only thing stopping was really that penalty, or they have been in great field position again. I think that's got to be the surprise to not only us, but the surprise to this 50-some thousand people here. They haven't had a whole lot to cheer about yet.
Grovey back into the huddle after his fifth interception of the season. He threw only three all of last year. Alabama up 16-7. Tennessee had scored, and then the very next play, Alabama ran it 75 yards for a touchdown. Illinois up early over Michigan State. And again, the option pitch, and look at the running room for James Rouse. Dan Malone steals him out of bounds after a gain of 9 yards. Malone, as we said, a true freshman from Houston Waltrip.
Well, did you see Rouse when he turned that corner? I'll tell you one thing, he put his head down and he was motoring around that corner. You know, he's under a lot of heat here because he's got all these backs that are coming up here. Gosh, he's got freshmen, he's got sophomores, juniors. They talk about a stable of backs. They really have them.
And when the year began, he was listed second team behind a redshirt freshman, E.D. Jackson. Now that's reversed. Foster turned away at first, and now we'll have to see where they mark him. Only needed one, and Dwayne Duncombe, the strong side linebacker, came up along with Oscar Giles.
It's tough to run up that middle. You have Duncombe in there, you have Hackamack, Rocky Allen in there, Brian Jones. They've just got some strength in that middle. That was probably the biggest question coming into this game, is whether Grovey could get outside, and if in fact he got outside, it would loosen up the middle and allow them to run those power plays up the middle. But if he wasn't able to get outside, it was going to be tough football all day up front.
Extra blocker in with the second tight end, Lindy Lindsey. He's in motion. They try Foster, no problem. First down, 42 of the Hogs before Anthony Curl grabbed it.
Boy, they just love this football. Now, you think Foster's going anywhere? Look at that stance. He's got all his feet, slides over, and watch this. Just put the head down, get that first down. Third down and foot, and again, Arkansas with a great conversion record. How many times they convert third down into first down?
53%. Is that an amazing
number? That is amazing. Most teams, if you're at 40%, you're really doing something, but they convert 53% of their third downs into first downs.
Will be again to Rouse on the pitch, and again, Malone comes up to make the stop. But they're pretty much one-on-one on both of those option turns on the corner. Grovey one-on-one, and then after he makes the pitch, one man, in this case Malone, has to make that tackle or he's gone.
Exactly right, and I can see that they're going to try to stop Grovey quick. They're not going to try to put pressure where they allow him to run down the line, fake the pitch, and turn up. They are going to stick him on the end of the line, and that's what they did that play. Make him pitch the ball as fast as you can, so that when he pitches it, it's about 3 to 4 yards deep in the backfield and then recover.
E.D. Jackson makes his first carry of the day, and they tried tackle, and he stopped at midfield. Lance Gunn came up from strong safety. E.D. Jackson stands for Edward Donald, unless you play with him.
Yeah,
in that case, it stands for extremely dangerous.
I think it is extremely dangerous. I'm talking with Kenny Hatfield. He said he may be the best one we've had here in a long while. He is really something. Kind of got nicked a little bit early in the season, but boy, he is a football player. Only a freshman.
First game, 97 yards. You said a little bit banged up, but they like his prospects. Third down, two. All over Grovey, quick pitch. Here's Jackson. First down to the horn, 44, a gain of six.
Boy, and Texas gambled that time. They thought that Foster was going to get the ball on that quick handoff. And I mean, Foster got smashed in there. Watch when he turns to his left. Watch number 18. Boom, right there. Great choice by Grovey to pull the ball out and flip it wide.
Well, we've already seen a lot of Van Malone. His first serious playing time against Oklahoma because of the injuries in the secondary. And he's been in on about every other stop here. Cedric Fillmore is in motion.
Come on,
Grovey again. Chase lets it fly. It is too tall for Tim Horton along the sideline. Good coverage over there by Mark Berry. Bo Robinson, 45, was the man putting pressure on Grovey.
Boy, that was interesting to see Robinson to run with Grovey. Grovey's got that great foot speed. When he ran out there, he didn't run away from Robinson on that play.
Well, the knock on Grovey his first 2 years, and it's a strange situation, was that they didn't think he was much of a passer. And you look at him, his first 2 years, his career percentage was just under 63%. So I don't know how he got the knock, because he disproved it every week.
Well, they always say that about running quarterbacks, because they said they would rather run than they would pass. But he certainly didn't. He's a great runner. He's a pure quarterback as far as passing, too. He's got that good foot speed to run, and he's got a strong arm.
Derrick Russell made that catch and then immediately dropped for a loss of about 3 yards. And Grovey says, boy, that should have gone for more than that.
Well, he threw the ball behind him, and that's what happened on that. You say drop for a loss, he kind of dropped himself a little bit, and that ball was a little bit behind him. That's a slip screen. Big down, you're inside the 50-yard line. You've got to get some offense going. This is a big, big play for Kenny Hatfield and his staff. They don't want to lose this momentum. The longer you allow Texas to lead in this football game, the more disadvantage you're at, especially if you're the home team when you want this crowd behind you.
Lets it go, and Todd Ringo has the interception. They will mark him down at the 2-yard line. Quinn Grovey, second interception of the day.
This ball just gets away from it. It's a floater. You can see good coverage there. Just looks the ball in. That's Todd Ringo. He just looks it in. Now he runs it into the end zone. His momentum didn't take him into the end zone, so they're going to bring it out to the 2-yard line.
Turnover number 2 by the Arkansas offense, but they've backed the Longhorns up.
Beale Street in old Milwaukee both means something great to these guys. Beale Street means a blues festival and spicy barbecue, Memphis style. And old Milwaukee means a great beer. Cold, crisp, old Milwaukee beer. Smooth, golden old Milwaukee light.
There's nothing like the flavor of a special place.
Old Milwaukee and Old Milwaukee Light.
This doesn't get any better than this.
Yeah.
You're looking sharp. You're looking good. You've come so far. And we know how to make the most of who you are. Father to son. It's what we've always done. Gillette.
The Gillette Atra Plus system and Gillette Foamy Shave Cream, together the best a man can get.
The best a man can get.
Accommodations arranged through Hilton and the Hilton Honors Program, which offers frequent travelers the fastest route to a free hotel stay. Call 1-800-HILTONS for details. It would have been hard to get a punt as good as that. They have the horns back at their own 2-yard line after the interception.
Absolutely. Great field position for the Arkansas Razorbacks.
So Winfred Tubbs straight up the middle for a couple. Tubbs, one of those true freshmen in the backfield out of Fairfield. Chad Rowland, the nose guard, a junior from Sherman, Texas, made the tackle.
You don't want to put a lot of pressure on your freshman quarterback, but this is a great position to throw in. You run that play action into the line, try to hold those linebackers, and find that short crossing patterns to pick up one of your wide receivers or your tight end sneaking out of there. And he's got a couple big targets in his tight end in Cash.
The full house backfield behind Gardner. And Samuels leading forward up to the 7-yard line. So that'll set up a 3rd and about 5.
Now this is where you got to stay low right here. And you can see Mr. Shepard gets a little bit high, Mike Shepard there. He's trying to fight across the face. He kind of takes the wrong angle on that. You've got to get underneath that lineman. You've got to be able to control him. And he is a good one, Mike Shepard. I guess it's Michael. But that's the way they had it listed on my program, Michael.
We'll go with Michael.
All right.
Horns had a couple of big third down pickups on their first drive. Not here, and that will be called down. No fumble, no Arkansas touchdown.
What a force by the cornerback on this play. You want to see what force is? The first thing you have to do is you have to come in and take out the lead blocker. Couldn't tell if it was Cooney or whether it was James. I didn't see who it was. The boy comes in, takes out the blocker, and boom.
Patrick Williams.
That is. It's Patrick Williams. Boy, this is a great play. You come in, you take out there. There's the fumble recovery, but of course it wasn't a fumble. But watch again to your right of your screen. You're going to see Patrick Williams come in there. He's number 24. Take out the interference and take down the running back. That's where you get the stars and the Razorbacks on your helmets and things like that. That's just a great play.
And you heard it a million times, but that was one where the ground had not caused a fumble. Chris Engel is down at the 7.
I was a little bit surprised on that. recollection, I thought, again, it's a good place to pass the ball, but you just don't want to make a mistake in this situation and put pressure on your team.
And Arkansas has called timeout here because they want Texas to have to punt into the wind. There's 33 seconds to go in the first quarter.
Smart heads-up play because the wind is, what would you say, probably 10, 15 miles an hour.
I would think at least that. The flag is stiff down there on the sideline, and so they'll have Tim Horton standing at the Texas 42, and there's an even better look at the wind. Lil Jadal about 8 yards deep in his end zone.
And I remember when we were down on the field, I watched the punters punt with the wind. With the wind, they were punting 50 yards. Into the wind, they were punting about 30 to 35 yards, so we'll have to see the result of this choice.
It up and it's off the side of his foot, and this is disaster for Texas. Look at the roll inside the 10-yard line. That is a punt of 0 yards, but a flag is down on the sideline.
Well, it's a flag. It's along the line of scrimmage. Oh boy, if this goes against Arkansas, they will have a I didn't see what the signal was.
Offsetting. That play is going to stand, it would appear.
Watch this ball when it comes off the foot. This is the worst nightmare for a punter. And Lil Jadal's a great punter. It just comes, look at it, look at the angle of the punt, the way it comes just straight off the side of his foot. What a decision here by Kenny Hatfield to call that timeout, to make him fight or punt into the wind. Not only the advantage of the wind, but psychological advantage, and it worked.
So here's Groby, first down and goal to go. E.D. Jackson, touchdown, Arkansas.
That's capitalizing on a mistake. In every football game, there are certain plays that you capitalize or you don't. And when you capitalize, you get the results. And the results of this play were 7 points.
Third touchdown run of the year by Jackson. Todd Wright is 19 of 20. He hasn't missed any field goals, but he has missed one PAT. High snap is handled, and the kick is good.
Watch this hole that E.D. Jackson just runs through. It just bursts up the middle. There he is, takes the handoff. Now look at the hole that just opens up. Boom, doesn't even get touched. So he just jogs into the end zone. You watch the hole just to the right now. Good block there, good double team. Right there, kick out, and look at this. Gets behind his blocker, and you can just see he just rolls into the end zone.
A little lean to the left is what set it up, and then the cutback. And E.D. Jackson has put the Hogs in front for the first time. 21 seconds to go in the first quarter. 7-3 Arkansas here. Elsewhere on our Dr. Pepper Roundup, Tennessee has come back in that battle of the top 10 unbeatens in the SEC. Still Illinois by 7, and TCU with a 6-3 lead over D. Dallas and the Air Force Academy.
That is a surprise. TCU, if they're able to hold on, they would really beat a good Air Force team. Run Arkansas, yowling continuously out of the Ozark Mountain.
He wins the vocabulary award. Not much on the drive, not much needed after that net 0 yard punt by Bobby Lil Jadal. And how out of character that was for him.
Oh.
He's been one of the top two punters the last 2 years in the
country. Absolutely. Comes into the game averaging almost 42 yards a kick. Even a bad kick, 30, 35 yards for him would have been a long way.
Speaking of long ones, Glenn Ray Hines Jr. drills this one way back, and Chris Samuels downs it with the Horn offense now set to march from their 20-yard line. There's Hines, his dad, of course, one of the great Razorbacks in their history.
And pro players. Of course, Glenn Ray Hines played with the Saints for a number of years. And great followers of his son. He has really enjoyed him.
Well, they had taken the crowd out of the game. And what did Ken Hatfield tell us yesterday? He thought the punting game, the kicking game, would decide this
thing. Oh, yes. He thought that the winning the kicking game was the big factor in this football game. And with a wind like that and the psychological advantage.
Adrian Walker did burst up the middle for about 8. Then Floor led the Arkansas tackling contingent, and that should be the last play of the first quarter. Well, last week, Texas got a touchdown off a fumbled punt in return against Oklahoma. Then they got a two-point conversion, and they won by four. So that was one reason that Hatfield thought it would be so important in what is usually such a close-fought series today. Through one quarter in the hills of Arkansas, the Razorbacks have the lead. Back after this message is from your local station. This is Raycom Sports. Dave Rowe, Dave Barnett in Fayetteville, 7-3 Arkansas. They have switched sides. And Bobby Liljedahl has some things to think about and work on after that zero-yard punt set up the Hogs for the six-yard touchdown run by E.D. Jackson.
And a lot of things to think about. The drop, the foot action, and kick it downfield.
Second and only two. Play action for Gardere. He will run it. Chad Rowland denies him first down yardage. Very mobile nose guard. There's Tony Allison, who is also chasing Gardere.
That was a nice move by the line, down the line to stop that run.
One thing that Lynn Amity, the offensive coordinator for Texas, likes about Gardere is he says at any point on game day, you can look at him, you can talk to him, and you never get the impression that he's nervous at all.
No, he said that Gardere came up to him this morning and said, "Hey, how you doing, coach?" He said, "We're in Portland. How are you doing, son?"
Third down, one, Gardere, timeout. Well, whatever he saw, that was a rather veteran-type decision to go ahead and call the timeout in a key third-down situation deep in their own end of the field. So while the horns talk about it, we'll break 14-17 to go in the first half.
Watch out!
So, 2 years in New York, and he thinks he can tell us how to run things.
It's all right. I fix things. He's traveling overnight on the red eye.
Not first class.
Business class, of course. Company policy.
He'll be hungry and tired.
Clump, British Airways' new business class, delivers you ready for business.
Pleasant trip.
Yes, thank you.
New club class for the businessman, only from the world's favorite airline.
About how key the third down situation would be today, and there's what the horns have done. They got their first one and then turned away on their last three chances.
And that showed that's keeping right in line with their 28% that Arkansas has allowed by the opponents to convert.
They only need one here. Keith Cash in motion, pitches to Adrian Walker, first down as he leaps over the 30, and then about three more. Here's the way the stats look after one quarter. And the yards passing, the only negative really for Arkansas. They did throw the two interceptions, but they more than made up for those by cashing in on the bad punt. Texas holding the ball twice as long is also interesting.
And a lot of it in that first drive when they were able to drive down and get in great field position for that field goal. But you were right, that one interception was almost better than a punt.
The way it worked out, it
was. Yes, very much so.
Gardere, the underneath pass is there for Kerry Cash. Arkansas's plan today is to give him those underneath passes and just don't let the speed of Walker and Jones get free long. Cash also pretty fast, but he's normally better down around the goal line where they can alley-oop the ball to him.
How many times have we seen Kerry Cash go up for that alley-oop then when they get down inside the 10-yard line? But I think the big thing for today for Gardere in Texas is to throw underneath those short 5 to 7 yard curls just like that pattern and don't try to challenge. Every once in a while you have to challenge downfield with a Walker or a Jones, but keep it simple and be very patient in your offense.
To the 41-yard line. That'll set up a third and short. Scott Long, the defensive tackle, freshman redshirt from Benton, Arkansas, on the tackle.
Long there, number 70, number 80, excuse me, is known more for a sacking. Good play right there. That's what you want to do. Hold, control your deep offensive lineman, and once you see the break, use him to push him away and move to the play. That's a heads-up play. He's a good football player.
He is their sack leader with 6 for the year. Third down, 2 needed. Gardere, option keeper, ball is free, Arkansas recovers. Nick Thomas, after Chad Rowland had made the hit on Gardere.
And this is the one, if you're Texas, you wish he hands it off to the upback because the upback goes right through there. Now watch right here, you'll see the footing slip. See the footing slip, and there's the ball just tipped and falling right out of his hands. He doesn't come back. Heads up play there by Nick Thomas. Only a sophomore transferred in here. I believe he's one of the junior college transfers.
And he leads them in tackles for the year. So again, the Hogs set up in great shape, and Groby barely hangs on to it as Shane Drenette came hurtling over his head. I would think we're deep enough into the game where nerves shouldn't be the problem.
No, once you get that first hit and you get that first contact, you kind of forget about all the outside parts of the game. It's just played there, down there on the field. But I think the thing that happened with Gardere is that his feet, he lost his footing. And when he lost his footing, he realized he was just trying to make short yardage and tried to stretch and make the first down, got hit and fumbled the ball.
So on second and 14, 2 wideouts, Horton and Russell, and Foster coughs it up. Big scramble, Horn say they have it at the 38, and they do.
Gosh, is this uncharacteristic of both these teams?
Ken Hackamack comes away with the third Texas takeaway of the afternoon. This is really strange. These two teams are among the best in the country at hanging on to the ball, except for today. It's 7-3 Razorbacks.
You're looking sharp. You're looking good. You've come so far. And we know how to make the most of who you are. Where the race is run, you're the champion. Gillette,
the Gillette Atra Plus system and Gillette Foamy Shave Cream. Together, the best a man can get.
So, 2 years in New York, and he thinks he can tell us how to run things.
It's all right. I fix things. He's traveling overnight on the red eye.
Not first class.
Business class, of course. Company policy.
He'll be hungry and tired.
Clunk, British Airways' new business class delivers you ready for business.
Pleasant trip.
Yes, thank you.
New club class for the businessman, only from the world's favorite airline.
Well, they've provided us with another historical angle. This is again shades of 20 years ago when Texas overcame 6 turnovers to win. That's the third Arkansas turnover already.
And that was the third fumble in the third play because First, Texas fumbled, then Arkansas fumbled twice on the two consecutive plays. That's amazing. That's just so uncharacteristic. And there, of course, Ken Hackamack, who recovered that fumble. But here's the fumble right there. He never gets the handoff. See the ball kind of squared out. Look at Hackamack. I got it. 6 foot, what, 6 foot eight?
10.
6 foot, excuse me, 10, 305 pounds.
Barry Foster coughed it up after Grovey almost did. And so Gardere back in business at his 39-yard line. Curtis Thrift in motion from tight end, and Gardere wants it all going deep, has his man, and Tony Jones has put Texas back in front.
The most amazing thing I see of this play is Gardere's just walking off the field. Everybody's slapping him. He's just walking off the field like it's a walk in the park. That is amazing. You have to keep those defensive secondaries honest, and you do that with that long play. And I'll tell you one thing, the last 10 yards of that play, Tony Jones showed that he might have that 4-2 speed that everybody talks about, because he just sprinted away from the coverage and burst to catch that ball in stride.
Michael James was the cornerback he beat for his second touchdown catch of the year. Now Wayne Clements, out of the hold of Lil Jadal, adds the extra point, and the Horns go on top 10-7.
Now watch this play right here. He just throws this as far as he can. That's just as hard as he can. Now watch the acceleration on the tail. And look at Jones accelerating, looking it all the way in. You can see he just runs away with that great speed.
And that, of course, brings up some very unpleasant memories, because he's the man that caught the game-winning touchdown in the last play 2 years ago. Now, he had to be, it's almost like they had to tell him that it was a touchdown.
I can't believe, look, he's just walking off like it's just nothing. I mean, they call him the cardiac kid, and there's Tony Jones. He's one of the cardiac kids. But I couldn't believe the reaction by Gardere. He walked off like, yep, there's another one. And again, we have a stunned Arkansas team, a stunned Arkansas crowd.
Our Schick permanent storyline changes now, obviously, after the Texas opening drive ended in a field goal. Jones on the first play after the Barry Foster fumble. Arkansas has run the ball well, but they can't hang on to it. Two interceptions and that fumble now cashed in as they trail again by three.
Don't you know that this Arkansas crowd is tired of hearing about Tony Jones? He has scored every game he has played against Texas. He has scored a touchdown.
Beat him 2 years ago, almost beat him. He had another long touchdown reception from Mark Murdock when he made his big splash in Austin against the Hawks last year. Clements now kicking with the wind, and Foster will not run it out from 3 yards deep. Hackamack got it started. Give him the position. Give him the possession to get the lead. And a flag is down on that kick up at the 43 of Arkansas.
I remember last year looking at Hackamack, he was about 6'9", about 285 or so, 290, and everybody said, oh, wait till he grows up. He grew up, now he's 6'10", 305 pounds, and still looks pretty thin.
Yeah, they've had to change his dimensions just since the press guy came out. That will be declined. It was illegal procedure, Arkansas. Texas says, we'll let him start from the 20. A series that always seems to go down to the wire, even though the Arkansas line today had them favored by about 14 points.
And my question right away is, what's Hackamack doing over there sitting drinking Kool-Aid? They must have brought in Tommy Jeter.
He's earned his rest. That's exactly what they've done. And James Patton is in at the other defensive tackle. Rouse and Foster in the eye behind Grovey. This is Foster. Good first down yardage. He's up to the 26, and a couple of freshmen, Shane Burnett and Anthony Curl, made the tackle. Foster, a Texan out of Duncanville, the leading rusher for the second straight year.
Hard to believe he has not been stopped for a negative yardage yet. He hasn't been caught in the backfield, and he's carried the ball coming into this game 63 times. That just shows that when he turns plants and gets upfield.
They keep a stat about that we'll talk about in a moment. That's Fillmore in motion. Rouse this time. He may be gone. Bierman and Gunn giving chase, and Rouse is knocked out of bounds inside the 25. 49 yards for the senior from Little Rock.
Well, I can tell you, when I saw Rouse run earlier, I thought he ran with a different vigor. And he does on this. Watch the cutback. That's where the hole is. Great vision we talked about earlier. Now look at this. He's a fullback. He's 225 pounds, and he's running out there with the secondary. And automatically, quickly, Texas makes a defensive change and brings back in Hackamack and Rocky Allen.
E.D. Jackson in to give Rouse a breather. He stopped for maybe a gain of one by Hackamack and Mark Barris. Well, the Razorbacks running backs coach Larry Brinson, the former Dallas Cowboy, says that Jackson and Rouse, two of the best he's ever seen, and also Foster, at yardage after contact. He keeps it steady. He looks at the films and he sees where they're hit first and then how much yardage they pick up. He says Foster and Jackson are two of the best he's ever coached.
And he said that with Jackson, he said, I can yell and scream at him and get right down on him. And boy, he never whimpers, doesn't do anything. He just comes right back and plays solid football.
Hogs go with three wideouts. Option pitch, Jackson. Stopped at the 16.
Big series here. This is where if you're a Texas fan, you've got to hold them to a field goal. Don't allow them to get in. This is, again, that third down conversion that we've talked about. Look at that update. That is really a shocker to me. TCU over Air Force, 13-3 in the second quarter.
Ironic that Air Force runs the wishbone. TCU goes to the air with their triple shoot. And we'll see them next week in Waco take on the Baylor Bears. What a wave of confidence a win today could give them. Third down, and they need four. They need the Texas 13. Quick rush put on. Ball delivered and caught. Tim Horton has it first down at the 9.
What a story in Tim Horton. 5'9", 177 pounds. His dad, one of the most successful coaches, and I think he's at University of Central Arkansas. Tim came here to play, and boy, that's just picture perfect. Great pass. Look at the plant. Quick out right there. Not the best trajectory on the ball, but he looks it all the way in, picks up that first down.
Only the second completion for Groby today and the first for positive yardage. Remember, Russell lost yardage on his catch. 11th reception of the year by Horton, their leader in that category, and their first down and goal to go. Blitz look put on by Brian Jones. Jackson gets nowhere. They stack him up.
I can tell you, if you don't stop Groby at the point, at the corner, and he gets outside and he has that run pass off the option, he puts tremendous pressure on those cornerbacks. You don't know whether to come up and try to stop the run or to drop back and hold and stay on your coverage.
Checks the cheat sheet there on the wristband.
Well, what that is that what they do is they give a number to the running back who comes in, or the, in that case, with Billy Winston, comes in and says play 7. He looks down on play 7, and he can call the play in this situation.
Play 7 is the option roll into the end zone, and Winston has it for the touchdown.
Seven must be to Billy Winston. He said, just throw it to me, I'll be open. He came across the back there and just was wide open.
Second touchdown catch of the year for the nephew of Dirk Winston, the former Arkansas and Pittsburgh Steeler grit. And so the seesaw game goes back to the Razorbacks, and Todd Wright, out of the hold of Gary Adams, will try to give him another 4-point lead. And it is blocked.
I think I saw Hackamack's hand come up there, but there's a flag down on the play.
We'll have to see if it will stand. It looked like Hackamack who got a hand on it. Offsides, Texas, so kick again.
Boy, and that could be a big play. I think Kenny Hatfield was right. This kicking game is so vitally important. A lot of people overlook that. And we heard all about the great field goal kickers on both teams. Both are good field goal kickers. But to block an extra point and then give the team the option to kick it again can really change the complexion of a football game.
That ball had a very low trajectory anyway, and it doesn't take much elevation by Hackamack at 6'10 to get a piece of it.
Well, they flood the middle. They put their big men in the middle trying to get penetration up the middle, and that's where you mostly block them.
It does cost Texas.
one more look at the touchdown catch by Winston.
Billy Winston, number 86, going to circle around here. He's going to fly out to the outside. Roby finds him. Now watch the bobble at the tail end of this. He has to get control of it, get both feet down in bounds, and he had control. Maybe we can watch it again from the angle. You're going to see him coming across to the left here. Now get out. Now watch Winston. He's right there in the bottom of your screen, wide open. Now watch when he gets the ball. Watch him get control of it. Pull it into your body, drags those feet, keeps that one in bounds.
Back and forth we go. Arkansas's turn to lead it by four.
Ever feel like you're getting nickeled and dimed to death? Take my old gas station. If I use their credit card, a dollar bought 96 cents worth of gas. For me, that 4 cents added up to about 50 bucks a year. So now I come here, Phillips 66. I get high detergent, super clean, unleaded gasoline for the same low price, cash or credit. I give them a dollar, they give me a dollar's worth of gas.
Cape Hatteras and Old Milwaukee both mean something great to these guys. Hatteras means surf casting for bluefish, and man, do they love to fight. And Old Milwaukee means a great beer. Cold, crisp Old Milwaukee beer. And smooth, golden Old Milwaukee light.
There's nothing like the flavor of a special place. And Old Milwaukee beer.
Old Milwaukee and Old Milwaukee light.
Hey, guys. This doesn't get any better than this.
Hi, I'm Grant Taft, Baylor University football coach, and this is my friend Jim Wacker.
And I am Jim Wacker, and boy, this weekend, it's the Baylor Bears against the TCU Horned Frogs, homecoming in Waco, and Grant Taft, you're going to have those Baylor Bears 10 feet off the ground.
That's the truth, Jim. But I'll tell you one thing. Most of the time in the last many, many years, both teams have been that high because it's a great rivalry. This Saturday, Raycom Sports and Entertainment.
Texas strikes on the long bomb to Tony Jones. Arkansas right back with a 49-yard run by James Rouse, setting up a 9-yard touchdown pass by Groby to Winston.
And I think they may have Tony Jones back returning.
They do.
That is a surprise. The reason they don't have him back there a lot more is they don't want to lose him, lose his great offensive threat.
He's going to get it if he can pick up the bounce. Top bounce from his 3-yard line. Got a nice block by Deion Cockrell, but only his own 8.
Well, he's exciting just getting out to the 8-yard line. All the footwork. And look there, I was kind of holding my breath thinking, well, he's going to break one. Well, they got great coverage. Well, he's going to break one, but went down on his 8. And that's just good special teams work. It plays such a vital part of the game. You know, I remember the days in football when the special teams were just all the big guys lining up and punting the ball. And today, it's about one-third of the practice is practicing on special teams, the kicking game.
Credit the good kick by Hines, the tackle by Mark Bell, and Texas in the eye. They give Adrian Walker out across the 10, not much more. Nick Thomas with another stop. What do we got here?
Go Hogs. Hi, Mom. Mom is at the...
And Mom needs money.
Mom needs money.
That's a twist.
What's that say? Love move? Send money to Mom.
Well, the magic of television.
Some people do anything to get on.
Gain of 2 for Adrian Walker. So in the passing set now, they've got 3 wideouts to the right and 1 to the left. And Gardier looks right and has Johnny Walker very close to what he needed for the first down. He may be the length of the ball shot. Michael James and Patrick Williams made the tackle.
You can see his ball. This is how the quarterback looks. Now watch the protection. Big protection up front there. He finds him out in the flat. This is just put your head down, get everything you can. They come up. It looks as if it's going to be just about, as you said, a foot short. Big third down play. You don't want to give the ball back to Arkansas. They now have momentum. They are really rolling along here.
In the full house, Jason Burleson, the best man they have to get 1 foot or so, because he's 6'5". He can lean forward and get a couple yards normally, and he's got the first down here. Burleson, a redshirt freshman out of Sherman.
Well, you know, that's 2 times in a row that Texas has had that terrible field position on that punt. When they were down on the 1 or 2 yard line, and now they only run the ball out to the 8. That's a long way to drive for an offense to recover from that. You like to get the ball out near the 30, 35 yard line. so you can kind of be a little bit more relaxed in your offensive attack.
Walker, the man in motion, and Gardere will run this one. Wrapped up, though, at the 21-yard line by Mackenzie Phillips, a sophomore from Springdale, Arkansas. He's the son of a former Outland Trophy winner, Lloyd Phillips.
I remember Lloyd Phillips, and if his son is the kind of player that Lloyd Phillips is, he'll be a great one. Of course, Lloyd Phillips came out in that class of, I guess it was about 67, we all came out together.
You dated yourself. We went after that.
Well, was that 1967, right?
Phillipson backing up Michael Shepard on that tackle. Gain of only one for Gardere. Looks to the sideline. Catch is made for the first down by Walker at the 32-yard line. He's gotten so much more activity this year as defensives have double-covered Tony Jones.
I looked at Adrian Walker. I think the ball it looked like it was intended to him. Watch Adrian Walker turn, and there you have in the back Johnny Walker, number one, who turns and makes the catch. But a nice throw over top of the coverage and back inside.
What a quandary a defensive coordinator would have. Who do you give double coverage to?
Well, both those outside wideouts, both Walker and Tony Jones, deserve double coverage. So what they've elected to do is try to play a zone and give the short pass and protect against the long one.
Adrian Walker, the cutback, pickup of about five. Ken Benson and Mick Thomas. Two of a very active group of linebackers for Arkansas with the tackle.
Well, one thing that I notice in both the team's plays here are they both have very solid offensive game plans. Run the ball, run it. Don't run that wild play where you're going to lose 15, 18 yards, or don't throw that threatening pass that can be intercepted. It's a very solid game plan, and that's why they've been successful. Both teams are utilizing their strengths. They're not gambling, so to speak.
We like a five-yard gain on first down, and that's what Walker got. This is Lamel Foreman. He's got 4-4 speed. He's got to turn it up. And Cooney prevented a touchdown at the 37 of Arkansas.
Boy, nice dip by Foreman. When you talk about a dip, that's where you dip into the line and hold that linebacker or that corner that's coming up to make the catch, make the tackle. Now watch right here on the right of your screen, you're going to see. Now watch the good block right there. Great block there by his wide receiver. See both receivers in the white? Great blocks right there. There's another block coming on back. That's the way you free up in the secondary. Boy, I'll tell you one thing, receivers get great credit when they watch the films, when they make downfield blocks like that.
When Texas failed to recruit Robert Strait and went to Baylor, Lamel Foreman helped ease their minds a little bit when they signed him. You saw why. On play action, here comes the blitz. Gardere hands it off. He's got Jones inside the 20-yard line and another Texas first down.
And I wondered whether Gardere could hear Ken Benson coming on the backside of him because number 42 leveled Gardere after he threw the football. Watch Gardere. Now watch coming from your left side of your screen. You're going to see number 42 coming in here. Boom. But he just finds Jones right in that little seam, that little pocket that's just a natural pocket on zone coverage. You run that curl at about 10, 12 yards, and it's just a natural pocket. And look at that record there, 8 of 9.
This is a freshman. Gardere, the inside give, and Burleson bouncing off Ty Mason up to the 15-yard line.
Pretty good ad-lib that time by Gardere. Did you see that? He came out wrong, didn't panic, just turned around and said, now, where are you, Burleson? And just handed the ball back to big Jason Burleson.
When you see that, no coach in the world can take credit for that. That is in the genes, and he is a third-generation Longhorn. His dad had a one-play career. He was hurt on the very first play, broke his neck as a sophomore, and that was the end, although the neck injury thankfully healed, and he's fine today. Foreman bobbled the pitch and may have lost one. Benson was all over him.
And this is where Arkansas really gets tough right here. You're going to see the Benson just jump across the line. Just boom, right there. He's right across the line. His job is to turn it back inside. He does an excellent job to turn that play back inside. Don't let it get outside of him. If it gets outside of him, he has no pursuit. Everybody's running after the play. Did a fine job on that defense.
Third down, 8. They need to get inside the Arkansas 10-yard line. Benson on the blitz. Gardere lets it fly
end zone, knocked away, but a flag is down.
I want to tell you how close that came. Tony Jones had a great shot. We're going to have to find out what the flag is, but Tony Jones had a great shot to catch that football.
Curtis Banks is the man that deflected it at the very last instant. That ball is inches away. And the penalty is against the Hornets. Illegal man downfield against Texas, caused by that extra scrambling time for Gardere.
Yeah, I believe Cunningham thought that Gardere was going to scramble, but a good move there by Gardere to gather his senses and realize that he wasn't going to be able to run it downfield. He was going to have to throw the ball, and he just kind of gathered himself quickly and still had a chance to complete that ball. Now, the decision there is, of course, it's a loss of down, a lineman downfield, I should say. And it's going to bring up a fourth down. And about, well, if they decide to not take the penalty as they do, it's going to be about fourth down and about eight.
Now, let's see if they perhaps missed a penalty here. Jason Burleson trying to prevent Vincent from sacking Gardere, and I would say
that is definitely holding, yes.
That might have
been. But that wasn't the call. But that wasn't the call on the play.
So a 34-yard attempt by Clements. He has already hit one today.
You'll get a good picture of it as it goes up.
Plenty of leg right through the middle.
And I think we've got everything that we expected. Rivalries outshine statistics and standings.
3 minutes, 3 seconds to go in the first half. It is Arkansas by one.
We met in pre-dental and opened our practice 15 years ago.
Best buddies?
Usually.
Usually.
Things work out.
It could be worse.
I'll tell you one thing, there aren't many guys I could work with.
Neither can I.
Right now, our primary concern is making sure the practice continues in case one of us,
bites the dust.
Bites the dust?
Well, you know what I mean.
Come on.
Jefferson Pilot Insurance and Financial Services.
Guys, you're not going to believe this. To hear Mike was named to GTE's Academic Honor Team. Everything comes easy to that guy. I'll bet he doesn't even have to study to get good grades. And he spends half his time at the pizza place.
The GTE Academic Honor Team was created to honor outstanding student athletes like Mike. Because we know not everyone gives them the recognition they deserve.
Win a free round trip for two to London, England on British Airways. Some lucky Southwest Conference fan will spend 5 days and four nights in beautiful London. For your chance to win, send a 3x5 postcard to this address in Charlotte, North Carolina. Entries must be postmarked by November 14th, and the winner will be selected by random drawing and announced during halftime of the Baylor-Texas game November 25th in Austin.
And you're probably going to say that we're not eligible to compete, right?
I'm afraid that's true. We've got time to change their minds. Scoring drive for Texas, capped off by Clements' second 34-yard field goal of the day, and he's inching closer to a pretty good milestone.
He certainly is. If he gets 60 kicks, there's only been 15 kickers that have kicked 60 field goals, and he coming into this game had 52. He now has, I guess he has 54 now. So he's inching, as you say, very close to just an outstanding record for a kicker.
It's a classic.
Barry Foster back waiting.
Clements is the kickoff man.
Foster looks kind of edgy back there. He's saying, I want to return one. Just kick the ball to me, and I want to return one.
Well, he may get a chance on this one. Nope. Down to his knee, 5 yards deep. We have yet to see a kick return from that end zone. So down to 3 minutes and 3 seconds in the first half, 14-13 Arkansas. They have taken turns leading this game, and a big defensive series here for the Hawks to keep Texas from regaining the lead by getting into the end zone.
And everybody talked about the big shootout, and there's the big shootout.
Biggest game in Southwest Conference history. A lot of people would say the best game in college football history, although not many of those folks from Arkansas. And in 1989, they both come in as the only unbeaten teams in the conference race, so whoever comes out of this one today is in control in the race for the Mobile Cotton Bowl. We'll talk about that race with Jim Williams, president of the Cotton Bowl Association, at halftime. Foster, big gainer, up to the 35 on first down.
Just the thing about that game, I think that we've had such a strong discussion in our production staff. We have, of course, Johnny Tyus from Arkansas. He's going to root for them. You know that. And of course, David Handler being from Texas, Lee Friday from Texas, and you're from Texas. I mean, we had to walk down to the 13-yard line where that famous catch was made.
We're on a historical setting here, but we're professionals. Remember that.
That's right.
We're seeing a great game on first down. Grover, the option pitch to Rouse. And 13 yards after Foster went for 15.
I want to tell you, I have seen James Rouse run before. But I noticed on that first run, when he put his head down, he was really running hard. And I notice that now. He is just running with it. It almost looks like he's a different runner. He's not picking his hole. He's just exploding into it. Look at that. That's just dead out running. I mean, that's just as hard as you can run.
Look at the collision between the two Longhorns, one of whom is still down with the bruised shoulder, and that's Todd Ringo, who was playing as much as he has the last 2 weeks because of further injuries in the secondary. We said Stanley Richard did not make the trip because of his banged up leg. They've had to shuffle at secondary, and Ringo has had quite a bit of action, but after banging his shoulder on this collision with Brian Jones, we got to wonder about it. Also got the head in there.
It looked as if he got hit up in the neck area, up in the throat. There's David McWilliams. He's certainly concerned. The foremost on his mind, of course, right now is the health of his young player, but he really expressed his just upsetness, I guess you'd say, the upset that he had with so many of his defensive players being down. He just said, if we had this, if we had so-and-so, we had Stanley Richard, we'd be all right. I mean, we could compete today.
Well, last year was the defensive line that got so banged up.
Right.
And it seems to have moved to the secondary this year. 14-13 Arkansas as they continue to look at Ringo with 2 minutes and 36 seconds to go before halftime. Arkansas, as we said, has won in this stadium against Texas only 3 times. They trail the all-time series 52-18, but they always find a way, these two teams, to seem to bring it down to the wire. We've got the makings of that today.
I know when you talk about tradition, you talk about wearing red when you come to this stadium, because as we look across, it is just a landscape of red. I think that it's got to be a rule that you have got to wear red when you come into this stadium.
Hadn't seemed to bother Texas over the years, and Mike Campbell, their former defensive coach, had the great line several years ago. He said, anytime you come into Arkansas, it's like parachuting into the Kremlin. and that's what he was talking about.
Well, when you stop and think of great football games, of course, that shootout certainly was one. They've asked some of the great coaches what their moments, their greatest moments have been, and of course, you've got a great moment to speak about, don't you, one of the coaches?
50 years ago today, this is the 50th anniversary of the day that the great Texas coach D.X. Bible thinks that the Horn program was made. They were not that great through the 30s, but on October 21st, 1939, they came from behind. Arkansas was up 13-7 with 15 seconds to go. Texas had it at its own 29. Jack Crane, who became a state legislator in Texas, took a pass from R.B. Patrick and went 71 yards for the touchdown. On the final play of the game, Texas came from behind to beat Arkansas 14-13. And D.X. Bible, one of the great names in Texas football history, says from that day forward, Texas was a football power. Now, 20 years ago, of course, was the culmination of that series. Some of the main players for Texas, what they've done since, James Street and Insurance in Austin. Jim Burleson had a nice career with the Rams. Randy Pescher, who caught the long bomb in banking in Austin, and Happy Feller is a doctor also in the Hill Country area in Fredericksburg. Arkansas, the quarterback Bill Montgomery, in banking in Dallas. Bill Burnett, who scored their first touchdown, a minister here in Arkansas, and Chuck Dykus, likewise, here in Arkansas.
Shows that football players can be successful, and there's a success. To see Todd Ringo get up and walk away from that. He was really stunned on that hit, and it's good to see him up and running around.
E.D. Jackson and Juju Harshaw are the setbacks, and Grovey, looking over the middle, has got Tim Horton, their third straight big gainer. 21 yards on the pickup to the Texas 31-yard line.
Boy, and as Grovey just delivers his ball, boom, he steps in there and throws a rope, and Horton just finds that seam, again, right in that little curl area. And the first thing you think is, why can't you defend that curl area? But it's a natural seam between the deeper coverage and the shorter coverage. It's just a natural seam in there, and that's the way it's designed to be run. Quarterback throws a rope, just a burner. Curler just takes it, and boom, looks it right in and catches it.
D. Jackson hit hard. as he got inside the 30 and then leaned forward. Boone Powell was the man on the tackle at the 27-yard line.
And you have to be a little bit aware of the clock. You've got 25, you've got a minute and 45 seconds you'll have before they run this play, maybe even less than that. They're out on the 26, 27-yard line, and they're predominantly a running team. With two timeouts left, they better utilize those timeouts to the best of their advantage.
Jackson got four. Groby, action keeper, got only a couple up to the 25. Hackamack and Jones turned him back inside.
We talked a lot about Edie Jones, but let's take a look at Brian Jones, number 60, playing off, sliding along right here, comes back. You get that arm on some of the best tackles that you'll ever make are those one-handed teardowns. Boy, and they're not in any hurry to run this clock. We're going to be under a minute here in a second. Well, maybe they're happy just to have a field goal.
Boy, how big a touchdown would be if they can manage. Option pitch again. Jackson, nowhere to go. He's going to be about a yard shy. And the team that has not missed a field goal since early last year apparently set up to have to think about trying to get their streak up to 34 in a row. The timeout has been called as they will discuss things with 39 seconds to go before halftime.
And interesting that they call the timeout with 39 seconds on the clock. If you're going to call a timeout there, usually you let the clock run all the way down. They may, in fact, try to go and run the fake field and go for it. You never know on this team. They've had such success with the field goal, it's almost an automatic 3 points, which would put them up 17-13. But they quickly called timeout with 39 seconds left. And usually you run it down to 4 or 5 seconds and then kick it.
Well, Todd Wright this year, 10 for 10, after Kendall Traynor made his last 23 last year. So the team has the record of 33 straight field goals. If Wright hits one today on this fourth down situation, it will be Arkansas's first here in Fayetteville since 1981, when they beat the number one ranked Longhorns 42-11. Greg Horn missed three field goal attempts in 1984, and that was when Jeff Ward hit five and they won 15-13.
And this is not an easy kick. There's the coaches up there. That's the brain trust up there, as they say. But this is not an easy kick because it's from the left hash mark, so that normally a soccer kicker has that hook when he comes off there. It's not an easy kick. It's going to be from the hash mark. It's not straight in. It's surprising that they called timeout with so much time left to give Texas a chance to get the football back.
Right, the redshirt freshman from Stillwater, Oklahoma, will try it out of Gary Adams' hold.
40 yards.
With the angle to the right. Streak is over. Pass is made, and Billy Winston has it, and let's see where they mark him down. They may have a first down.
This may be the biggest play of the year.
And this is an instant replay of what Texas did on their extra point last week. That is amazing.
What a heads-up play. Watch this. The ball's going to be bounced right back to him. Now watch Wright pick it up. He knows he can't get outside. Shuffle passes it forward. Winston comes down with it and in enough room to get the first down. Maybe they did know something about that. There's the block. Now watch right here. I know I can't make it. I just flip it up there. Billy Winston, first down. Oh, boy, could this be a big play.
First down gain by Harshaw with that much time remaining, but a flag is down, so they stop the clock at 23 seconds.
And Lance Gunn didn't retaliate on that. This is going to be an interesting. This flag was thrown in an altercation between an Arkansas player and a Texas player. And the Texas player looked as if he didn't do anything afterwards. However, I think the flag was thrown early. Let's see what the call, in fact, is. There it is, dead ball, personal foul, and it's against Texas.
And he's been ejected. So we'll try and pick up who it was.
Well, in fact, it might be Lance Gunn. He was the one who got shoved pretty hard. He may have done something beforehand in order to necessitate that. Yes, it is. He's going off the football field. Boy, it's hard to lose your starting safety.
Boy, they're so depleted back there anyway. And so Grady Cadness, a true freshman, a great one, they feel will be one of the best secondary players ever at Texas. Boy, that's
one of the few backups along with Bubba Jacks, and then they saw Todd Ringo get banged up as well.
See, what I think he's saying there is I got hit, and then I retaliated, and they saw that. That may be what he was, in fact, saying. It's hard to speculate, but he has, in fact, been thrown out of the football game.
Bubba Jacks is the man that has replaced Gunn.
23 seconds left.
And before they come up to the line, the scoreboard was incorrect. I'm not sure if that is why the officials didn't let the snap go. It showed first and three. Of course, it's first down and goal at the six. And how big that blocked field goal ending the streak of 33 in a row now looms. What a weird game. We've seen as much weirdness as was in Texas, Oklahoma last week.
And what a heads-up play by Wright to throw that football. That's got to be the play of the day so far, to throw that football, have the forethought just to throw it. He didn't throw it like Garo Yupremian did he?
Thankfully for Arkansas, no. Roby on the roll, into the middle, wide open, but knocked away by Bubba Jacks, the man who just came in for Lance Gunn. It looked like Winston had his second touchdown catch.
Oh, he did. That ball was just delivered perfectly. Now watch Jacks come back in here, just get a hand in there. Look right there, just a hand in there to knock that ball away. Again, watch it. Groby pulls up here, finds Winston in the back of the end zone, and watch the hand come in there just to knock it off. That's what you call an all-out play. He was stretched out as far as he could. And that young man says, hey, there's no drop-off when I come in here.
Second down and goal. Here comes the rush. Flag down, Groby down. No, still going. And Quinn Groby is in, but let's see what the flag means.
There's several flags down. And Texas, they are waving their hands.
You always think holding or illegal procedure. At the line, that's what it was. Only 11 seconds before halftime.
And this is one of the big ones. This takes it back from about the, 5 or 6 yard line. It could take it back. It's going to be a legal motion. Look at Kenny Hatfield's reaction. Now the big play, Dave, is whether you call a running play and try to get a quick timeout. They have one timeout left, or you throw a pass, but you only have 11 seconds, so you've got to call a quick timeout if you don't score.
Here comes the blitz, and Brian Jones is all over Quinn Groby. So much for that idea. And the clock rolling at 5, and still no timeout at 3, and at 2, and double zeros, and unbelievably, Arkansas is ruled evidently not to have had any timeouts remaining, although the scoreboard clock says that they had one remaining.
What a heads-up play by Texas. The scoreboard clock did say one, and that's what led me to believe that they were going to try to run a quick play. But perhaps they, in afterthought, hindsight, it's always best to call a timeout and kick the kick.
But incredible that they didn't take the kick opportunity, and Jones came on the blitz right up the middle, buried Quinn Groby, and so we have reached halftime in a game that has lived up to its billing, 14-13 Arkansas. Today's game is brought to you by Jefferson Pilot Life Insurance Company, by British Airways, by Budweiser, and by Phillips 66. It's halftime, and we'll be back after these messages from your local station. This is the Raycom Sports and Entertainment Network.
What is a learning environment? It's a place where outstanding faculty and bright, eager students interact to pursue new ideas and stretch the imagination. It's a place where peoples of different cultures and backgrounds come together to broaden understanding. It's a place where excellent resources spawn the best results. It's a place like the University of Texas at Austin.
The University of Arkansas leads the world race to produce higher temperature superconductors. The Arkansas research team is headed by Drs. Alan Herman and Jinshi Shang.
It's been said that the Arkansas discovery, the thallium calcium barium copper oxide superconductors, are really the first high temperature superconductors that can work at liquid nitrogen temperature. Liquid nitrogen is plentiful and inexpensive.
The potential effect of these discoveries is staggering. The fact is, today's research is tomorrow's future.
He can tell us how to run things.
It's all right. I fix things. He's traveling overnight on the red eye.
Not first class.
Business class, of course. Company policy.
He'll be hungry and tired.
Klung, British Airways' new business class delivers you ready for business.
Pleasant trip.
Yes, thank you.
New club class for the businessman, only from the world's favorite airline.
That's my son. You know, he could grow up to be one of the world's great doctors. Yeah, maybe a...
Budweiser halftime stats.
Doctors measure back pain by how far you can bend. Extra Strength Dones is made for back pain relief with an ingredient these pain relievers don't have. Dones makes back pain go away. Extra Strength Dones, made for back pain relief.
It looked like another boring month. He was going to rearrange his sock drawer. She thought they'd fix the cat. Then they discovered Southwest Airlines Fun Fairs. Soon they were jetting away from just $19 to all sorts of exciting cities, seeing things their mothers had warned them about, eating food they couldn't pronounce, laughing out loud for no apparent reason. Southwest Airlines Fun Fairs. If you've got $19, they're available now. If not, never mind.
And we'll have fun, fun, fun flying Southwest on a fun fair today.
Hi, you hear about the used car?
Hi, got a cold drink.
Sure. She's a beauty. Oof, I'm itching to get my hands on her. Dr. Pepper, great. Now about the car.
Yes.
Hi, you good for your daughter? Are you busy tonight?
Doctors measure back pain by how far you can bend. Extra Strength Dones is made for back pain relief with an ingredient these pain relievers don't have. Dones makes back pain go away. Extra Strength Dones, the back specialist.
Today's game is brought to you by Coors Light. By the new Schick Slim Twin Razor System. By Citgo. And by Jefferson Pilot Life Insurance Company. 14-13 Arkansas over the Longhorns of Texas. Lots of big plays in the first half, and here is just one of the many.
You talked about this ended the string of 33 consecutive field goals, which was the NCAA record. Now watch the heads-up play by Wright. Throws it, completes it to Billy Winston, first down. But, Dave, they did not capitalize on it. You cannot get down here with an opportunity against this fine Texas team and not come away with at least 3 points.
And, by the way, Shane Drenet, it looked like number 81, blocking that kick. Jim Williams talked about the Cotton Bowl coming up January 1st. Here's how you can get your tickets. Call 214-638-BOWL Monday through Friday.
That's easy to remember. B-O-W-L. It's going to be quite a Cotton Bowl this year.
David McWilliams certainly has his team positioned. If they can come from 1 point back here at halftime and win, they'll be 3-0. They'll have one of their toughest road trips out of the way, although they also have to go to Houston and Texas A&M. Arkansas next week will host Houston at Little Rock, and that one's already sold out, 53,000 plus. And then they've also, of course, got the Aggies later on their schedule as well. So a lot of the bigger games will come now week in, week out. Somebody's going to be playing somebody else, all with Cotton Bowl impact. Arkansas will kick it away. Glenn Ray Hines had a nice first half doing that. And he will kick with the wind. And it's a low bouncer. Kaplis and Samuels are back deep. Chris Samuels lets it go. Back to what Texas had to keep in mind today.
Well, first of all, maintain confidence. I think Gardner has really instilled confidence in this Texas team. They now believe that they can slow down the Arkansas rushing attack. 26 carries, 151 yards. Sounds like an overwhelming amount, but it's just a little bit less than average first half for this Arkansas team. And involved Tony Jones, and boy, did they do it with a 61-yard touchdown pass.
And one of their near misses was on their opening series where he seemed to have a touchdown on an end around and then fumbled the ball. Samuels is hit by Nick Thomas, who had a strained neck and had to sit out part of the second quarter. Also in on the stop, Tony Allison. Samuels getting a lot of first half action along with Adrian Walker and Linnell Foreman, who played for the first time today. Not quite the depth that the Arkansas running back position has, but it's a position that's even without Eric Metcalf, probably deeper than it was last year for Texas.
Well, it is when you think of Burleson back there and his talent's only a freshman. Tubbs is another freshman. They have some good talent upcoming.
Gardner to the sideline, and the open man is Walker for a first down at the Arkansas 37-yard line. Anthony Cooney with the coverage, and again, Gardner able to find the open man underneath the zone.
Well, in that first half, Gardner was 8 of 10, as you said, with 142 yards. Of that 142 yards, he had 116 of those yards to Walker and Jones, so that shows you where he's going. He will continually go to the wideouts as long as they give him a cushion like that. When the defensive back plays that far off, you can throw those 10, 12-yard outs and curls very easily.
Terry Cash in motion on the ground. Nowhere for Samuels, and he does well to get all the way up to the 36-yard line. May have lost one. Michael James and Ty Mason were there to bring him down. Interesting when talking about the Arkansas secondary. They average allowing only 150 passing yards per game. Texas is already above that with that completion one play ago.
But this is a strong Arkansas defense. They play an excellent team defense. There's no one outstanding pass an Atwater back there. They are all consistent, good football players. They play a team concept, and that's why they've been so productive with their defensive statistics.
No gain on first down, and play action on second for Gardner. Again to the sideline to Walker, and again a first down. When do they start to have to make an adjustment on that?
Well, who do you double cover? That's the big question. You've got Walker on one side who's got outstanding speed, and you have to give him a cushion. You have to give him distance. Watch Gardner find him right there. Boom. He had his choice then. He could have picked up Kerry Cash, but he saw Walker downfield a little bit more. What you have to do is you either gamble and try to get pressure on the quarterback and scare him, or else you drop back and try to cover. There you are. There's the passing for game.
Gardner taking what they're given. That's what Lynn Amity wants him to do. Adrian Walker stopped as he reached the 45, only about two. Owen Kelly, Tony Allison, Ty Mason, all right there.
I looked down there and Chad Rowland, the nose tackle, saying, I was held. And when he pointed at the referee, he said, look right there. And he had his arm wrapped right around he had someone's arm wrapped around his leg. There's a Texas fan, wasn't it?
I'm not sure. He had the score right, but if he's a Texas fan, he had to hook them wrong.
Late score.
A 1 week late score. Second down and 9, and the double reverse, and Jones with a 4-2 speed turns it up, and now outside, and would appear to have a first down. But they like for him to get at least 20 or 30 on that. That's about what he's averaged on the ground this year.
Well, this is good backside containment. When I talked about the team concept, you've got one player that has to turn it in. You see him right there? I think it was number 57. That's the outside backer. He's got to turn that play in. If he lets it get around him, then you pick up the 20, 30 yards. But that's team concept. Everybody has a responsibility. Everybody plays their responsibility, and they played it very well on that play.
Jones has averaged 22 yards a carry. He got the first down here. And now Adrian Walker's turn. Good blocking, cuts it up. Nick Thomas held him to a gain of only two. So evidently, whatever neck problem he had, he's worked out at halftime. Elsewhere on our Dr. Pepper Roundup, Florida has a 14-0 lead over New Mexico. Baylor 8-0 at Waco over Texas A&M. And Oklahoma struggling in the first quarter with the Cyclones.
And there you see Tennessee, Alabama leading in 33-24. That's still in the third quarter. Michigan State, Illinois tied 7-7. And how about TCU and Arkansas, TCU and the Air Force, 20-3 in the third quarter. So that would be a morale booster for TCU.
Again, the underneath pass, Kerry Cash got inside the 30. And Shannon Wright, one of only two true freshmen playing for this Arkansas team. The Arkansas Defensive Player of the Year last year, Fort Smith, made the tackle. This is going to set up third down and a long four.
It's been a long time since I've seen Gardere miss a pass. He has got several in a row.
11 out of 13 for the day for 175 yards for Gardere. Rolling on the rush, Gardere. Walker juggled it and made the grab at the 14.
And Dave, the hardest pass to catch or hardest pass to throw is when you're running to your left as Gardere, as he runs to his left and throws his pattern. Again, see the curl right there on the 15-yard line. The defensive secondary dropping deep. It's a two-deep zone, and he's just picking them apart.
He had a 5-yard pad. Now, you got to be closer than that if you're Michael James.
Well, Arkansas usually lets you catch it in front of them and then comes up and they make you pay for it. They'll let you have those little ones.
On first down, Samuels trying to knife back toward the middle. He got near the 10. Good mixture of the ground and the air on this drive.
Well, it's a good game plan on both coaches. Both coaches utilizing what they do best. That time rolling Gardere. I didn't know that he could throw that well on the run. Running to your left is hard to throw for a right-handed quarterback because you have to throw across your body. But he drilled a bullet in there.
Well, he was no more as a passer than a runner in high school. One of the top three or four yardage-wise in high school history in Texas. On the option pitch, there's some room, and Samuels managed to stay up after he almost slipped at the 11.
I don't know how he stayed up.
I don't either.
It looked as if he put a hand down or something, because his feet had definitely slipped out from underneath him, but he gained his balance to instead break maybe even. Watch right here. You see the feet go out from under. There goes the hand. No knee touching. And then explodes through a little hole, picks up three or four more yards. That's the sign of great running backs. Again, that leg strength, those quick legs, you get those feet up and down. It's not a trudging type of thing like you think of a lineman.
Well, they mark him down at the 7, third down and 3 to keep the drive going. And it is Samuel again, and on second effort, where they mark it will depend, but he looks like he's got a first down and goal at the 3-yard line, and he does. Tough inside.
That was. That really surprised. Now watch this coming right at you. Watch Samuels. Boom, he gets hit here. Now good cut back into the hole. Now he almost gets the ball ripped out here. Now watch him stretch. That's just what you call, that is just hard football.
And then Aaron Jackson looked like an inadvertent grab of the face mask. Too many bodies around evidently for the referees to see. First and goal at the 2. And it is Keith Cash trying to leap into the end zone, the wide receiver playing running back here. Nolan and Mason kept him out.
Well, we know about Keith Cash, the football player. We also know about Keith Cash, the basketball player. And that time he got up. Looked like he was going to dunk it for a second, getting up in the air.
You wish that they gave you the stat on his vertical leap.
It's quite a leap. He's got just excellent strength. This is just power football. Punch it in.
Touchdown,
Texas.
And
David McWilliams is saying we're going to go for two after the touchdown by the freshman from Fairfield.
Well, if he goes for two, that'll give him a 21-14 point lead. 6 points. If he goes for one, it's only a 6-point lead. If he goes for two, it's really, you know, it's not really a real gamble because you need at least a 7-point lead. Then you put the pressure back on Arkansas. What do they do the next time they score? Notice I say the next time they score.
You have to assume that they will. The only setback is Samuels. Jones there in motion. And the gift straight up the middle, and Chris Samuels almost standing up has the 2-point conversion. They stretch out the line, and he punches right through the middle.
Everybody thinks pass on that play. Now, this is the touchdown. This is just power football. This is Tubbs up the middle. Big person up there, 240 pounds, 6'5", freshman. He just barrels in there. Now, this play, they stretch. This is the extra point. You see how wide the splits are? Everybody's thinking pass or run wide. He just cuts it back inside and goes in, as you said, standing up.
Life's more interesting when you make a splash.
It's the right beer now.
If you feel a great beer, starts with great water.
It's the right beer now.
Because you're the kind of person who likes to get to the bottom of things, call for the silver bullet, the one that won't slow you down.
Coors Light. It's the right beer now.
Aye. What are you doing? Hey, Dave, where'd you get that chin?
What's wrong with my chin?
Where'd you get that nose?
It's Dad's.
How do you shave under that thing?
Now there's a razor as unique as the Thomas face. The new Slim Twin razor system. Slim Twin has the slimmest cartridge to shave hard-to-reach places. And a choice of pivot or fixed head shaving.
Dave, I'd give Dad back his nose.
What's wrong with my nose?
New Slim Twin reaches every place on every face. From Schick.
Boy, what an impressive drive that was. 14 plays and 80 yards into the wind where Texas has scored all 21 of their points today.
They certainly did. They took the opening kickoff, drove all the way down.
They did have the one field goal toward the end.
Right, but they drove the length of the field with the opening kickoff, and now they come back with a 14-play, 80-yard drive. Very impressive. Led by that freshman quarterback, Gardere.
All but the 34-yard field goal late in the first half by Clemens has been against the wind. And Barry Foster, again, standing at his 10-yard line, so he expects...
So typical of a rivalry, and the rivalry that we talked about, this rivalry being one of the top four or five rivalries in the country. You can throw away all the stats, all the records, all the scores, how well you did against this team and how well the other team did against them. You can throw it all out the window when you play this game.
Foster had it judged about right, but it bounces away from him, and he better down that ball because it's live, and now they finally get the touchback. Back to what we talked about earlier that Arkansas had to do.
Well, they had to take control early. They really have not done that. They've never taken Texas out of this football game. Dominate on special teams. Well, they hit that play, but they didn't capitalize off it. And they certainly have not rattled Peter Gardere. He has just had an exceptional day. Gardere sitting out there, and you see Quinn Grovey's statistics, but Gardere coming down and leading his team here. Gosh, 12 of 14, 191 yards. That's not a freshman.
Not much of a freshman. Doesn't act like one. Rousen Foster in the eye. Grovey with the pitch to Rouse. And the first man to hit him was Rocky Allen. He may have stretched forward for one or two.
And I'll tell you what great teams do. Great teams, whether it be Texas or whether it be Arkansas, always answer the call. They always answer. You see the statistics under Gardere, 12 and 14, 190 yards. But great teams come back and they answer. And this Arkansas team is a great football team. They are. They didn't get to be where they are ranked nationally because they just were lucky.
No, you're not lucky if you win 16 out of 17, as they have, and there was early movement, and we'll see whether it was Mark Henry, 65, or Rocky Allen who moved first. It was Henry.
See, you continually put pressure. Arkansas, they react and they work much better when they're in that second down and safe. maybe 6 to 10 yard range, 6 to 8 yard range than they do when they come up and they're looking at a second down and 12, 14. It almost automatically takes the run out of the game plan.
They've been good in the past last couple of years because they've been able to do it when they wanted to. One key today you had to figure was whether they had to pass or whether they chose to pass. They keep it on the ground. And E.D. Jackson got a couple and then immediately a fired up Texas defense drove him back.
And if they don't convert this third down, we may see the first punt. Believe that, the first punt by Arkansas. They haven't punted today.
Now, we talked about the third down prowess of Arkansas. They averaged 53% for the year, their opponents 28%, and they've needed about the same amount on third down. Arkansas is about right at their season percentage.
Well, and this is a big one.
Straight drop, and Groby has a look, and he's got a freshman, Ron Dickerson, but he didn't get near the first down yardage. Ron Dickerson may be their biggest offensive recruit out of State College, Pennsylvania. How'd the Nittany Lions let him get away?
Well, his father is a coach there at Penn State, and he let the decision be his son's. He said, son, you go where you want to go, and the young man chose the University of Arkansas.
Ron Dickerson, an outstanding high school running back, and his dad also was roommates in college at Kansas State of the Razorbacks' strength coach, John Stuckey. First punt of the day for Alan Meacham. He's been a little bit banged up, hasn't practiced in a couple of weeks. Samuels from his 35 is flung forward for a gain of about 5 on the return. So Texas in control on the scoreboard and back in possession as we play in the third.
It's a feeling of power, of substance and style.
Texas 21-14. They passed almost at will today. Now does Arkansas have to abandon that ball control, let them throw inside the defensive scheme?
Well, I think you've got to cover the wideouts a little bit closer, but I think they're afraid of getting burned. And they may do a double coverage wideout, run the safeties, both safeties, to pick up Walker and Jones on the outside, but the running game is still there.
Chris Samuel spinning inside the 41, maybe the 42. Ty Mason hit him first, and then Michael Shepard. Forget later on today, Dave and I will be selecting the Coors Player of the Game at the conclusion of today's telecast, so please stay with us.
This is an important series. You know, every series, you hate to say that this is an important series, but Arkansas needs to get the ball back and need to take control of this football game if they're in fact going to be successful. They cannot allow Gardner to take them back down the field again.
This is Lamel Foreman. Not much, maybe one. Curtis Banks and Tony Ollison made the tackle. And meanwhile, on the Arkansas sideline, their all-conference defensive tackle being worked on. Michael Shepard had a banged-up shoulder and now walking back up and may go back in just from the looks of things. His backup is Mackenzie Phillips. Only one on each of the first two on this drive by Texas as you look at Shepard. So third down and 8 needed. They're a pretty good third down team themselves today. Gardner has Samuels, who does not get the first down. Ty Mason wrapped him up before he got to midfield, and then Aaron Jackson helped out.
And they put some pressure on Gardner for the first time. They were able to get the pressure up in his face, and they're going to have to, in fact, point it away. Now watch. lots of pressure here. You're going to see number 70 and 51. That's a loop in there. That's Chad Rowland. And I don't know who that is. That's Mackenzie Phillips. Excuse me. I shouldn't say who that is. But that's Mackenzie Phillips. They did a little loop in there, and they got up in his face and caused him to throw that ball quicker.
Bill Jadal involved in the first big play on the zero-yard punt, setting up E.D. Jackson's first Arkansas touchdown. This one, a perfect nose-down spiral and a fair catch by Tim Horton at the 14. 4:52 in the third quarter. Arkansas will try to drive for the tying score.
I like catching a ride. The fire in your eyes. Heading upstream. Girl of my dreams. And cold, coarse beer.
It takes a part of this country as cold and clean as the Rockies to brew a beer as pure and natural as Coors. Brew refresh. Just like you like it.
Have an ice cold Coors with a friend of yours.
A Rocky Mountain legend. An American ritual.
Big defensive stop there by the Arkansas defense.
That was a very important one. Now I look for Arkansas to take that ball and try to drive it and do what they do best. That's run, control, football, run the ball down and find a way to get that, to get some offensive continuity back. They've had a chance to sit over here on the sideline, and all of a sudden the whole complexion of the game changes. You got offensive linemen saying, we can do it, let's get out there. Texas on the other side saying, we can stop it.
James Rouse stopped on first down after he got to the 15. Rouse with the big 51-yard gain to set up an Arkansas touchdown in the first half. Only two other Hogs have ever gained 1,000 yards in the season. Ben Cowens did it three times, and Dickie Morton did it twice. And that's a little surprising when you consider the long history of great running backs that they've had here.
Well, you talk about long history. They have a long list also of running backs. When you stop and look at the running backs that they have in their backfield right now, they've got six running backs that are class running backs, could start for most college teams.
Give up the middle, and there is that yardage after contact by Barry Foster that we talked about. Foster almost never goes down on the initial hit.
Very compact, 5'10", 220 pounds. He's just a compact player. Now watch this. Now here's the contact. Boom. Now, how many yards does he get afterwards? Look at that. Boom. Doesn't fall back. Referee, get out of my way.
Got about eight, it looked like. And Arkansas set up first down now at the 24. Hackamack and Duncombe finally able to make the tackle. And limping off, another Longhorn, looks like Rocky Allen, who saw his season end in this game last year when he injured a knee after a career-high 12 tackles. Foster this time sat upon, only maybe a one-yard gain.
Now what Arkansas is trying to do is they're trying to get that established running right up the gut, try to hit Foster two or three times in there, so you tighten down the linebackers. All of a sudden, when you pull it out of Foster and you go wide, you've got that pitch option.
Well, we'll wait and see if we get word on Rocky Allen. That position was the most banged up for Texas last year. This year, it has been the secondary. Three wide outs. And they keep it on the ground to Foster, and again he drags tacklers forward to the 33. Brian Jones down there along with Boone Powell. Right past the initial defensive surge by the line and into the linebacker area.
Well, that tightens it up right there. That's what you try to do. You try to run that thing right up the gut here. Now watch right here. Give it to Foster. Boom. Now look right here. Bam. You can see he's just pulling away. See every, and that's, well, look at that block in the background. Boy, that was a deep leader in the background, whoever got that hit.
Big play here on third and one. And again, three wideouts. Roby, quick pitch, bobbled, and Jackson is stopped for a loss.
They'd had such success through the middle, they decided to go wide this time, and he almost coughed it up.
Well, watch how quickly Groby has to pitch this ball. Boom, right there, I have to pitch it. You see how quickly he was getting? And he just didn't have time to lay it out there softly. He had to drill the ball out there. That's one thing that Texas has been able to do. They've been able to stop Groby at the corners and make him pitch that ball. And Groby's rushing statistics are nothing like they were last week.
Shane Drenette made that hit, causing the quick pitch. Second fumble by Jackson today. And the second punt by Alan Neachams. A good one from the 25, Samuels. Up to the 38. Not great speed, but he knows where the holes are in the punt return game. Texas up by 7. Good field position at their 38-yard line. Real late in the third quarter.
Oh, no. Hey, Buzzface.
Matthew, did you lose your razor?
I can't get around my Adam's apple.
You can't get around half your face.
You can reach every place on your face with the new Slim Twin razor system. Slim Twin has the slimmest cartridge to shave hard to reach places, and a choice of pivot or fixed head shaving.
That's pretty good. How do I look?
Ugly.
New Slim Twin reaches every place on every face. From Schick.
Hey, guys and grills. Got some party time tips for you from Extra Gold Draft. First, never party with anything less than the full tilt taste of Extra Gold. This is serious beer. Another tip. You know, at a party like this, it's a good idea to keep a close eye on the family pet. Oh, little buddy, how you been? Come here. Yeah. Oh, you didn't think that.
Go for the full tilt taste of Extra Gold.
You guys are sick. It's all right, man.
Travel arranged through Continental, which has a new foreign policy offering upgrades and companion tickets for first and business class international passengers. Call Continental for details. 21-14 Texas, and the Longhorns start from the 38-yard line. 1:54 in the third quarter. And Gardere again to the side. Tony Jones caught it. Inbounds, first down, Arkansas 44.
Boy, it's a good thing Jones had those fast feet, because he was backing out of bounds, and watch the feet once he catches it. Has to have 1 foot in bounds. There it is. He's got 1 foot in bounds and steps out of bounds. Again, that sideline pattern, those curls, and you just keep on giving. That's a tough defensive play, but you have to respect that speed that they have at their outside wide receivers.
The draw, loss. Adrian Walker stopped by Chad Rowland. He was at home in the offensive backfield. He's got 4 sacks this year. Michael Shepard, by the way, okay after getting the blow on the shoulder, and he's back in the game.
Well, those front linemen for Arkansas have certainly played well. Allison with 17 to 20 tackles, I guess it is, and Rowland with over 20 tackles. Michael Shepard with 26 tackles. They've played very strong football up front versus the run. But now they have to get past, they have to get rush on the quarterback. You've got to get pressure on him. It's definitely a pass situation.
Jones over the middle, big hit. Knocked into his own man, Kerry Cash, but he hangs onto the ball and another Longhorn first down. This one to the 27th. Michael James delivers the blow here.
This is a crossing pattern in the middle. Watch right here. Make the break and bend to the post. You see it right there in the middle? Now that was man-to-man coverage that time. That's not bad coverage, but Gardere is really on. I'll tell you, it's been a long time since I've seen a quarterback, any freshman quarterback, complete 15 of 17 for 233 yards already. He is just having a marvelous day.
All they want him to do is take what's given, and that's all he's done today. Well, he's almost perfect.
He's very calm back in there. You just don't look for that in a freshman.
Just his third game as a starter. First down and 10, Adrian Walker. There was a gap. He ran into his own man, and he'll settle for a gain of maybe 4 yards. Walker still alternating with Chris Samuels at the tailback. Mason and Rowland for the Arkansas tackle.
You know, if my stat man doesn't betray me here.
Kirk McCarley would never betray anyone.
If he doesn't betray me, I don't think Gardere has had an incompletion.